Today, finally, we're launching GPT-5, a significant step along our path to AGI. It is useful, it is smart, it is fast, and it's intuitive. Now it's like talking to an expert, a legitimate PhD-level expert in anything, any area you need, on demand, that can help you with whatever your goals are.
Okay, you just heard it from the man himself. You all know ChatGPT just released its newest flagship model, o5, and Sam says you're all gonna love it. Well, are we? I took it to the test and I did some rigorous tests in the real world. Does it perform? Does it perform with code? Does it perform with reasoning? Does it perform with research as well as they say it do? Because you know, on all of these shows, they're always tooting all their bells and whistles and everything that they can do, but I wanna actually see if they can. So in this video, you'll see exactly side by side ChatGPT-5 with Claude Opus 4.1, their newest model that they just released more or less silently in the last few days. We'll see which one performs best. In the initial test, I just want to take it through something rather easy. We're going to do a little game and we're going to compare them side by side. We're going to put in the prompt here and we're going to do the same thing with Claude and we're going to click enter on the same time. There we go. Now we'll see pretty quickly Claude is finished faster, and I also like the style and UI a little bit better. Now when we compare side by side with what ChatGPT got as an output here, I think they're more or less the same, but Claude is a little bit more sophisticated. I don't know, I'm not a UX UI designer, but what do you think? Leave it in the comments if you prefer one or the other design and tell me why. Now on to the next test. We're gonna do a little reasoning test. We're gonna put in the prompt here about this broken leg theory and we're gonna see how they both perform against each other. And really quickly, we're realizing that Claude again is winning against ChatGPT because they just provided faster. And honestly, if I look at the complexity of this output, it seems a little bit more sophisticated. Even though they both have the exact same result, obviously that it's not possible that you need 7 times, it looks a little more detailed and just to the point the way Claude is describing it, and it was faster. I also want to see a little bit of research because I heard ChatGPT-5 was really good in doing research, and it will also use the deep research functionality to figure out on its own if that makes sense or not, and how deep this research should actually be. We put it to the test. Let's look at the state of EV batteries all around the world. What interests me about this topic is I'm no expert whatsoever. I have no idea which companies have gone how far and are performing and whatnot. So this is all completely new to me. Although the answers are similar, they're not exactly the same. We see Claude referencing some more Chinese, Japanese companies here like Toyota, and also later down in some other names that we haven't heard before, while ChatGPT is only mentioning some of these common names also more commonly used in the US. Even though they're citing some Chinese sources and articles, it looks pretty biased here in this respect. Just for a fun fact, I used DeepSeek, our Chinese friend LLM, which is still free, by the way, if you didn't know, to do the same research, and all of the companies there again match Toyota being number one, and then again some more Chinese and Japanese companies that are at the forefront of this right now. Is the model biased and feeding us wrong information, or is it just simply taking the news articles that it can find and finding different sources based on a different kind of Google search or whatever that is performing? I don't know exactly, but if you do, please educate me in the comments so that I can do another test like this, showcase some more results on looking at the different models and which one performs better. I know you're not looking for all these cliche tests and things that we don't really need, so I decided to test ChatGPT-5 with a real world use case. We know we're all here because we want to learn how to use AI to get more sales, to do better marketing and become more known, get more leads. So I use that to then use this for something that I use every day. And it's a little bit of a sophisticated app script that I've written to analyze YouTube channels, basically scrape YouTube data. This is all legal. In fact, it's provided by Google themselves using the YouTube API. What it does is it allows me to analyze different YouTube channels, different keywords, and it gives me an overview of which titles are performing, which thumbnails are performing, what kind of topics are really blowing up right now on YouTube so that I can create content around those topics at the same time. So what I want to do is I want to take this script that I have, is now an app script file and a sheets, and it works perfectly fine, but I want to see if ChatGPT-5 or Claude can come up with a better, nicer UI and build this app for me so that I can use it, maybe give it to some of my employees, or maybe share it with all of you guys. Maybe we can build a little SaaS application around it so that we can actively use this. Okay, so I'm gonna take this app script, I'm gonna leave a little voice prompt here on ChatGPT, and I'm gonna do the exact same thing for Claude. Now we're gonna see really quickly, I didn't type it in properly on Claude, so I didn't know what to do. Now I fixed that, and now they're both trying to build this app. ChatGPT is giving me a bunch of different files and said, okay, you gotta zip this and deploy it. But I'm not technical, so I don't know how to deploy this. Let me ask it. And Claude, on the other hand, already started to build out this artifact. Even though I'm not really impressed by the UI here, I do like that it tries it all in one go. So I don't need to zip any files or upload anything somewhere else, but it's actually trying to run this thing in Claude. And it's giving me a console, so it's providing the errors in real time, and it's allowing me to actually look at this and debug this while we're building it, which is kind of insane. Obviously, I go back to Claude, I'm trying to fix this a little bit, and ChatGPT said it can't deploy it for me, but here are the instructions to deploy it as an app script. So I follow all of these instructions, I put it into an app script, but I get an error. This is really common when you're trying to build any kind of code on these platforms. When they get really detached from each other, it gets more and more difficult to actually fix these errors if you're a non-technical person. Tools like Lovable, Replit, and Cursor have all been working really hard in the last recent months to fix this, to make it as easy in one place to actually build and launch an application that you don't need to go and upload files somewhere else and connect it with databases that you don't really know how to do it, so that you can all do it with one click. It uses these keys called tokens where it connects with other applications, like for example, Supabase for a database, and it then deploys it. Or for example, Netlify as a front end, and it will communicate in the background with all of these apps and do all the programming for you so that you don't really notice what's going on and it's just being done and the website or the app is just being built. That's what I really like about this approach by Claude. It's not really getting there, even though it tried to do a little bit of a better UI here, it's still not working as it should. I know I can probably fix this, might take me a little bit more time. However, ChatGPT is really not fixable at this point. It went back, but it didn't give me the output that I was looking for. In the end, you've seen a couple of these use cases. Claude was faster for every single one, and I felt that the results were way superior, especially when it comes to writing or coding. I don't know what you think. Leave it in the comments and follow and like for more of this content if you want to see more of these videos. And if you have any feedback or anything to add, let me know in the comments so that I can address that in my next video. See you on the next one.